So I finally watched Cardi B's and Meg Thee Stallion's video, WAP, and here's my thoughts. What's the big problem? What are you guys complaining about? I see people constantly complaining about it. I saw part of Ben Shapiro's little rant on it. First off, don't listen to anything Ben Shapiro says, okay? Like, this guy is not a good person to listen to. He carries around facts about how everybody else is bad, but not him. Don't trust somebody like that. Really? Tell me something bad about you. How are you so good at saying all the problems that are in the minority community, but you can't tell me one about you? So first off, don't listen to Ben Shapiro. Second off, that motherfucker is probably terrible in the bedroom, and that's why he hates this whole narrative video that they put out there. So let's break that down a little bit. So the video is all about women enjoying their sexual experience. What's wrong with that? Why is that a problem? I know why it's a problem, but honestly, for the goal of sexual experiences, the point is to own it and enjoy it. Now, I'll say this. If your ultimate sexual experience is at the hands of somebody else's discomfort or, the criminalization of their innocence, well, then you need to step back, all right? We're not talking to you. You are not a human to me. If you have to destroy somebody in order to get off, I don't ever want to meet you. I don't think you're a good person. I think you're a broken soul, and you need to go get help. That's what I'm gonna say to those people. And if I'm really being honest, I want those people to get chemically castrated. But on to the concerns of the video. So, as a fan of hip hop, I understand the narrative that has chased it forever, its entire history, which is this good for our kids? Are they learning a culture that we should be worried about? Are they going to act out just like the songs tell them to act out? Well, let me tell you this, all right? That's my number one music source, okay? I love hip hop, especially 90s gangster rap, all right? That's just what I got into. So I was listening to Dre the Chronic, Snoop's Doggy Style, Ready to Die, Life After Death, All Eyes on Me, all right? I was listening to all of it, the Slim Shady LP, and here's a crazy truth that's gonna blow your mind. I didn't start doing anything like drugs or drinking until 35. And even then, I do it very moderately, where I can't even finish a full joint. One joint once took me an entire month to actually get through, if that. I'm being lenient. I think it was more than that, but I kind of want to sound cool to the potheads. I never even picked up a gun until I was at a gun range. That's how little hip hop influenced me. But there's the problem. It's not music, movies, art, culture that should be influencing your choices in life. It's your parents. I mean, you can be influenced by the lifestyle of the culture. You can dress hip hop, you can learn how to dance hip hop, you can even learn how to rap, right? But the influence of art should never kind of make you debate what is morally right or wrong. That's where your upbringing is the big component. And I mean, there's no manual on parenthood, there's books, but they can only kind of give you tips. It doesn't really work out individually. I guess where my parents did right is A, I never saw them do anything illicit in front of me. I don't know if they ever did, but I never saw them get drunk. I rarely saw them smoke cigarettes. My dad did that. But it wasn't like they were walking around the house or at parties at any given moment messed up. So maybe that helped. And honestly, I didn't see my relatives do that either, so either my parents shielded me from that or my relatives were responsible people. I mean, I guess I could come from a long line of responsible people. I don't know. But we're dealing with a type of parent that apparently allows media to raise their children, and I get it, it's tougher now because you're forced to work more. You're not in the house as much. You're not really having family dinners because it takes so much time to cook, and it's so much easier to just buy an already made dinner. So the idea of parenting has changed, and you kind of have allowed these athletes and these celebrities and these entertainers to come into your children's lives and shape the way they think. And in that sense, I guess it is a parent's responsibility to teach their children on how to be aware of other people's thoughts to be able to process them and see how those thoughts actually fit in what they want to do in life and not feel as if those thoughts are the only way to go, because that's what it is. How do your kids deal with peer pressure is what they're eventually going to do, because it's their peers that kind of influence them to be bad. If you teach your child to be able to look at their peers and not be afraid of their acceptance and say, you know what, that's not for me, well, they probably have a better chance of not being influenced by something as stupid as a rap song or an internet challenge like we saw with Tide Pod and stuff. So you as a parent have to decide, am I going to arm my child with every mental weapon that they would possibly need to just deal with the world and strangers and interactions and friends and peers and boyfriends and girlfriends and all of that, so that they are able to get through life without dealing with as many hardships as possible, because you're going to deal with hardship. You have to tell them that so that they're not so broken down by it. But they can limit the hardships. Maybe some of the hardships aren't like, well, I had a massive drug addiction. No, I learned that I could not do drugs because they might lead to that addiction, so I just avoided drugs. Do you understand me? Do you kind of get the influence that you as a parent has? And I think as a parent, your biggest task is to help your child learn how to deal with their emotions, because their emotions are going to direct them. All of us make decisions based off of emotions, and if you don't know how to control it because you saw your mom or dad not being able to handle it themselves, well then you will probably make bad decisions. And Cardi B and Meg Thee Stallion are going to be a blip in the entirety of human history, okay? So your worry about their influence on women's sexuality, as if there hasn't been anything else that has influenced women to enjoy their own sexuality, well, I will say this. There's one major characteristic that is probably affecting your life if you think that they are a problem, and the one major characteristic that everyone judges you on. You are a bitter, judgmental bitch. I get it, you feel superior because you like to compare your lives to those underneath you in your own mind, and it makes you feel good to be like, well, I'm not like them, and you judge people for how they dress and what they do and how they act, and nobody really likes you, because if you are judging somebody you don't even know, well then of course you're judging your family and friends. You're not a good person. You're somebody that constantly looks at other people's flaws so you can degrade them in your own mind, so you are prepared for arguments that are probably not going to happen, where you can insult them specifically to hurt their feelings and make them know how worthless you want them to feel. Are you that person? You probably are. So let's get a little judgmental on your fucking ass. Stop worrying about other people's sexuality. There are so many people that are shaming others for what they enjoy or how they enjoy their own sexuality. It's like, really? You're the one to talk? And I know why they're doing it. And they're doing it mostly because they are having a terrible sex life. Uh-oh, surprise. Do you mean that judgmental people are upset with other people that may have, be having a better version of what they desire for themselves? Possibly. And as a man, a woman who you will never, ever, ever get in the bedroom, her sex life is not your concern. Because trust me, none of us are ready for a Cardi B or a Meg Thee Stallion, okay? Most of us can barely handle Target Kathy, alright? Cardi B and Meg Thee Stallion, that's a whole nother echelon of woman that you need to figure out how to satisfy them, alright? That's a whole nother level, and if you can satisfy that woman, well, you might be a fucking samurai, honestly. I mean, it's time that we are honest with ourselves as men about less than 15% of the men out there have given women orgasms. Less than 15 have actually pleasured the woman that they're with. I know it's a hard thing to believe. You're like, what are you talking about, man? I jackhammer like great. Well, yeah, you fuck like a rabbit that knows that a coyote's nearby. That doesn't mean that you're good at sex. So I understand your fears of like, oh no, here's these women that are talking about their sexuality and I have not reached any of the things they said. I don't know anything about what they're claiming that they desire. It's like my version of dirty is just missionary with my clothes still on. And to any actual freak out there, somebody that has actually enjoyed sex, what they said in the video was very tame. That's like, really? That's as crazy as it gets for you? All right, yeah, that's possible. Yeah, it's very doable. And, you know, we can do that within a time limit, too. We can both go to bed at a decent time while accomplishing everything that you just said you wanted. That's how tame the sexual nature of that video really is. Then again, when I grew up, one of the hit songs on, like, school trips was Put It In Your Mouth. You remember that song? Oh my god, and that was way more vulgar than what I just listened to. WAP? No. Put it in my mouth. In my motherfucking mouth. So if you think this shit is vulgar, well then you really need to move away from Cinemax porn. That softcore ain't doing anything good for you. And that leads me to another observation. The problem with the Ben Shapiros of the world is that they are constantly watching other people. They are constantly carrying around stats about other people. They are so focused on how others act. In fact, they're ready to throw out studies about how you aren't great and how you are terrible, but they never focus on themselves. And beyond that, they are obsessed with things that they can't obtain, and maybe that's why these type of guys buy fast cars that they can never really race, that they can only take fast for maybe a minute at a time before they are too fearful of the cops stopping them because they're not race car drivers, they're just regular people. Or maybe they want these women that are out of their league and they obsess over these women that they would never even pleasure if they got these women, and they're so obsessed with things that they cannot accomplish and things that they cannot conquer, and it breaks them down and it makes them judgmental and it makes them shitty people and bad in the bedroom and hateful and ugly and just these little trolls that go and they just hammer and hammer and hammer somebody's life and their choices and just be like, you're wrong, you didn't do it right, you're terrible, you're not the chosen one, I'm ready to tell you how bad you are. Wait, is that me? So in conclusion, this song is not a problem. It's just a song. Don't listen to it. If you're a parent that is worried about your child listening to this song and becoming a slut, well, that's on you. What have you taught them of their morals? And have you taught them to be prepared? Have you talked to them about being ready for it? Because it's probably going to happen. Your child is probably going to meet somebody that they're going to be like, I am attracted to this person beyond just friends and just want to know more about them and feel them. Well, prepare them. Tell them about it. Let them know how the signs or how to get prepared and how not to be nervous and how to get away when it's a bad situation. Do not make them fearful of their own sexuality because you never got a chance to actually explore yours. And to all the online trolls, don't take anything that I said and try to warp it into something that it isn't. I know you guys like to do that shit. You like to take something that is meaningful and you're like, well, what he could have meant by this, fuck you, get out of here. You're exactly the type that I'm talking about. And as a man, I'm going to say, if anything in this song offended you, well, you need to step it up in the bedroom. You need to focus more on your girl, all right? So the next time you have sex with your girl, make sure that she comes first. You know, even try to make her come before you even give yourself any pleasure, all right? Don't be selfish. That's on you. If this song bothers you that much, we all know that you are a selfish man in the bedroom. And honestly, you are disappointing all of us. Because you're giving us all a bad name. Because women think all men are terrible, thanks to you. But on another note, thanks to you, I'm looked at as a good dude just because I actually pay attention and do my best to make the girl satisfied. I mean, I'm not going to say that I'm great, but I'm in quite a few all-star teams. And I know some of you guys out there are like, well, that's just big dick energy that you have to have. Well, that doesn't even relate to the size of your penis. Do you understand that? That's why it's an energy. Big dick energy is confidence and understanding and knowing how to pleasure a woman. That's big dick energy. And finally, as a hip hop head, I heard the song. I understood it. I once owned a Lil' Kim CD and I was like, alright, I get it. And if it comes on at the club and a girl wants to dance that song, let her dance. If I'm there, I'll enjoy it. If a girl wants to just walk down the street and jam to that song, let her jam to that song. And that's about as much as I feel about it music-wise. It's not something that I would rock. It's not something that I'm probably going to listen to ever again. I'm probably never going to see the video again. Because I feel like once you get the point, you know, it's not like Busta Rhymes, put your hands where my eyes can see, where you're like, yo, the visuals are mind-blowing, this is some crazy shit. It's just like, yeah, I get it. It's a rap video. And major props to Cardi B and Meg Thee Stallion for finding a way to have a hit song during this time. I mean, that's what they're supposed to do. They're artists that make songs exactly like that, and to have a hit right now, good job, man. You did it. You guys know the formula. You know what works. And in the end, whether you enjoy it or not, your responsibilities are all your own responsibility. So let's stop with the judging. We really need to stop that shit because it helps none of us. It just makes you a bitter person that, honestly, I wouldn't doubt probably causes like low-key stomach cancer when you're so judgmental and judgy and vicious and jealous and envious of other people. It's not good for your soul. So stop that. And to anybody that listens to Ben Shapiro, what's wrong with you? You're gonna listen to that guy on how life should be handled? Really? I listened to that dude for 20 seconds and I was like, this guy probably loses it at the airport when the gate changes. You're gonna listen to that dude? You're telling me that that dude has his life under control? Somebody who is so afraid of saying on his streaming show, pussy? Like that's, ooh, and also this is the lyrics. And he just repeated the lyrics that weren't even actually part of the song. It's sampled. So it's like, that's not even the song that you're having problems with. That's a previous song. That's a whole nother artist. And you're lumping it in with this one. Like, he's not even aware enough to know that that chant is from a completely different song that has been accepted for decades. It's like an 80s song, if I'm correct. Well, probably like late 80s, 90s. But come on, that's his biggest issue? Don't listen to that man. And I've seen his other videos. I've seen what he thinks about black people. So obviously his views are completely skewed and hateful. He has stats for black-on-black crime as if crime isn't just crime. And he's just ready to tell you and this and that. And I'm going to tell you how bad your race is. But he can't tell you how bad he is. He can't tell you how bad his race is. Don't trust that man. That's a broken human being who is only out for your impressionable dollar. He wants to get your fear nickels. That's what he wants. He wants all the little bits of money that he can pull from you by causing fear and making you accept your judgmentalness. Like, he's like, no, it's okay. You're justified in being judgmental. Fuck Ben Shapiro and fuck anybody that doesn't realize that it's on you to raise your kids. And this video is absolutely nothing in the entire history of humanity. It's just a moment. And I hope you took this moment with me. I need to go to bed. Thank you guys for listening. And stop worrying about rap music, please. It's been like almost 40 years of people worrying about fucking rap music. There's entire generations of fucking rappers are now going to be able to claim, well, I guess not because Trump wrote it out. They're not going to be able to get the Medicare or Social Security that was promised to retirees. That's a whole nother topic. All right, guys. Bye-bye.